I'm going to do several things this time in Space Engineers. Test our latest minor renovations, add some more firepower to the mothership, deal with this wreck we've had parked beside us, ablaze with burning components, and give you a rundown of the Assertive Combat Systems mod I'm going to activate, which will probably give us great regrets, but I'm going to do it anyway. In the last episode, I refitted the miner with a lot of upgrades and defenses. I'm anxious to get this thing out into space and test it out. The space station I'm planning on building will need a lot of resources, particularly iron, so I've added another large cargo container, and I think I'll test out the new miner on some asteroid iron nodes. While out mining, I want to explain what the bigger plan is and what this Assertive Combat System mod is all about. The plan, and what the last few episodes of preparation are all about, is to prepare for what should be a major combat defensive and offensive battle, while still trying to advance our engineering efforts and create a large mobile space station. The Assertive Combat Systems mod is an aggregate mod of what used to be several mods, all centered around making a very challenging combat experience. How it works is like this. The mod spawns in cargo ships and bases for planets, moons, and space, which will progressively increase in challenge as I grow in threat. The cargo ships will spawn in locally to my area as long as they can find a safe path to fly in. The pathing part is more of a thing in mountainous areas on a planet. The bases will attempt to spawn as I move around. The further I travel, the more that will spawn. On planets and moons, the flatter the ground, the more that will spawn. Now, if I leave this assert faction alone, it'll leave me alone. If I start attacking or get too close, that will change. In order to defend themselves more effectively, the cargo ships and bases will call in drones for help. And from what I've seen while doing some experimentation, these drones are no joke. They are well-designed, well-armed, and well-armored. In fact, as my threat increases, it seems these drones come in larger and larger waves, but I truly don't know what the limits are. To give credit where it's due, these drones and the mod as a whole has been constructed by Splitsie, who is another content creator who puts out excellent videos, and if you haven't seen his content, you should check it out. These enemies are different than the space pirates, in that they are more assertive. Because they spawn in your location where you're moving about, mining or whatever, they really become unavoidable. And even though I said that if you leave them alone, they'll leave you alone, at the same time, you'll need to give them a bit of space, or they'll start defending their area. So combined with the fact that they spawn in your area, total avoidance becomes difficult without getting pinned down. And if you don't deal with them and clear out their ships or bases and drones, they'll get so numerous that when a conflict does break out, I imagine you'll become swarmed and completely overwhelmed. So you can see why I've been trying to get myself a little prepared. And I'm hoping I'll be able to get enough of a space station assembled and defended before things start to get really bad. It's also why I went out on the mining run for iron and got that traveling distance done before launching the mod. With my upgraded miner, I was able to mine out 2 nodes of iron from the asteroids, and the triple connector ejectors were able to keep up with the excess stone removal as I mined. Just perfect. Now though, it's time for a couple more mothership upgrades so we can leave. First is more engines. Since landing on the moon, I've been adding and building and stockpiling resources, and have made this whole ship 3 to 4 times heavier than when I got here. So more engines are required, and a couple more hydrogen engines on each side should give me plenty of lift to leave the moon, and probably enough for landing on an Earth-like planet gravity. And again, I've got my great little welder drone to make quick work of the assembly. See how my plans are all coming together?
Everything is going as planned.
So with that, It's time for some serious defenses, because this mothership is holding everything I've gathered and built since the beginning of this series. So losing it would be a big setback. My plan is simply to bristle the outside of this ship with a bunch of large grid turrets and hope that by using pure firepower volume, I can take down any enemy drones quickly before they can do any serious damage. The new engines have provided easily accessible ports to mount some turrets, and I really like being able to put guns on the sides of my ships because it feels like I get a really wide range of coverage. But I need guns everywhere. Front, top, bottom, just everywhere. I'll first get some of these easier to reach ones up and welded, then work on the underside of the ship, which will be a little trickier because I still want to be able to land the ship, but we'll engineer a solution for it, I've no doubt. It's here though, with these first turrets, I ran into a little problem. Each time I welded up a new turret, it started firing at the enemy wreck I had parked next to me. Now, what I did is just turn off the turret after welding it, but I still didn't like it slowly turning my salvage into scrap and using up my ammo. I also tried for an hour or so to try to find every block on the wreck that I didn't have direct control over, grind it to a hack stage, and then build it back to gain ownership. But I just couldn't find all the blocks. So some of them were still being identified as enemy and making my guns fire. There's probably a mod out there that highlights non-owned blocks, which feels a little bit like a cheat, but maybe there's just a better way to fully gain control of every block of the ship. If there is, I'd love to read about it in the video comments. I've tried some of the shortcuts folks have posted, but I still can't seem to get control unless I grind and recontrol every functional block. But I need to deal with this ship one way or another, and I decided I didn't want to drag it with me to the new space station. So I was going to grind it down and do it with a small bit of engineering. So with my mining ship, I thought about just replacing all the mining heads with grinders, but that would have messed up all my control settings, and I just didn't want to do that. So instead, I made a little detachable grinding rig. With this, I could attach it to the connector on the bottom of my mining ship. And if I needed to unload the containers, fly it over and attach the bottom of the grinding rig to the mothership and dump everything. This whole rig worked remarkably well, and I truly thought that I'd have to make a couple trips to unload the contents. But this miner was able to completely gobble up the entire massive ship in a single load, and even go back and nibble up many of the little bits and pieces left on the ground. I know this probably just sounds like a proud space engineer parent, but it was truly a testament to the capacity and flexibility of the miner that I've kept slowly improving upon. So I am proud. The only things left were a few scraps on the ground, and just three or four trips by hand cleaned up all those little bits lying around. Now it was on to adding the rest of my guns and getting ready for liftoff. I needed two things here: adequate routing of conveyors for ammo to the guns, and enough space under the bottom of the ship. The turrets need a full 3x3x3 clearance, and depth-wise, when I landed it, I only had two blocks of clearance, so I needed to extend the landing gear by at least one block. Now, I considered and really wanted to create some retracting and extending landing gear, but it would have required way too many changes. So I went with the simple method of just adding a block. Lifting the ship off the ground and letting it hover was also the easy way. Though again, I did briefly consider making some sort of jacking system with the pistons. There's so many ways to do things in the game.
There are always alternatives.
While hovering, it also provided another nice demonstration of how subgrids affect a ship's balance and aren't controlled by your gyroscopes. I talked about that in another video, which is where I started using merge blocks as a way to get better stability while in gravity. With the new landing gear, it was a simple matter of making a few holes in the floor where I knew there'd be access ports above to put in a conveyor block, add some guns to both the front and to the rear of the ship on the undercarriage, and voila, I had protection on the bottom. I did make a few visual improvements, tidying up a few things and just giving the ship a final inspection, and I'm really glad I did, because I found what could have been a major flaw. These turrets potentially could have destroyed my miner. Let me explain. It seems that the automatic turret won't shoot at its own grid. So for instance, if a gun is tracking and firing at an enemy, and the enemy flies behind some part of your ship, the guns will stop firing until the enemy is back into a clear line of sight. Now, there can be a few incidental shots that can hit your own base or ship, so it's not perfect, but that's generally how it works. What it seems, though, is that the turrets won't stop firing when one of your own separate grids or subgrids gets in the way. The turret will continue to try to fire on the enemy even though it's behind one of your subgrids. Now, I haven't had enough combat experience, and particularly in that specific situation, to actually witness this for myself, but this behavior is what has been said about turrets, so I'm going to believe it. I realized a couple of turrets just had to go, but my miner was in real jeopardy from my main topside turrets. I thought maybe I could build a temporary wall with glass or something connected to my main grid, but that didn't seem like it would work well, so the miner just had to be moved to a safe place on the rear deck. Other subgrids, like my control room on hinges, was below the firing ability of the turrets, so I think I'm good to go on the rest of the ship, as far as making it destroy itself. I did need some more ice though, because I was basically out after hovering my mothership for 15 or 20 minutes. I had plenty of hydrogen, but I didn't want to leave the moon without some ice in reserve, because this mothership is all hydrogen powered. And when I leave the moon in my next episode, I'll also be turning on the Assertive Combat Systems mod. So scavenging for ice while I search for a new home could create some really interesting enemy challenges. This assertive mod could have disastrous results, or maybe it'll be brilliant and exciting. Guess we'll find out in the next episode. See you next time.